everyone, welcome back to our daily blog series, and we're on quite a rainy day today. However, we're continuing looking at the book Prayer by Philip Yancey, and we're almost at the end of the book, currently in the end of chapter 12, I believe. And in particular, we're looking at the heading Yearning for Fluency within his book Prayer, and we're looking at Two Worlds, the chapter titled Two Worlds as well. So Yancey talks about how in medieval times and also in the modern day today and within our society, that within our church monasteries, that the chiming of a church bell would often cause those that hear it to stop and say prescribed prayer. And it's kind of talking as well how those people that hear the chime of the bell would then be forced to remember God. And I really think it's, in a way, us, again, yearning for that fluency of prayer. So linking how he talks about yearning of fluency, but also almost like a constant reaction and like a repetitive repeat of action and motion, that when you hear that bell or that chime, when people would basically be instructed or encouraged to pray, and it becomes like that repeated pattern. And I think he goes on to say as well that when I pray, it may seem that I am narrowing my world, retreating from the real world into a prayer closet in Jesus' metaphor, but actually I am entering another world, just as real but invisible, a world that has power to change both me, but also the world I seem to be retreating from. So again, it really like sums up and describes this image of two worlds and that metaphor being two worlds, and how we perhaps have our prayer world and that prayer life, and sometimes we're probably all guilty of not always maybe being constant within it, but the prayer is like one world of prayer and our constant reminder that God is all around us, and that encouragement when we do pray, and the world of prayer and what we are asking for, because like I said before, like it is a constant conversation and that ongoing interaction with God and that connection within our faith and with God himself. But then there's also this other image perhaps where we perhaps may be narrowing our world because we're retreating from the real world into a prayer closet, like Yancey said. So it's almost like I just said, we have our prayer world, but also the world where it's just our daily lives. Like, and I think we've said before, and like I said, sometimes we may feel guilty that we're constantly just going on and about our daily business and perhaps going to work or doing our hobbies or seeing family or friends, or going on holidays, whatever it might be, that perhaps sometimes in the day-to-day life and day-to-day busyness, that we perhaps often feel guilty because we miss the opportunity for prayer, or we get up or go to bed and we've forgotten or missed out that chance of connecting and interacting with God through prayer. So I think it's really important that we remember that there is this other world almost, and that connection that connects us with God through our faith and religion. I think Yancey also really sums up kind of this peaceful and almost mindfulness that it is when we pray, like it's a peace of mind almost, and often quite relaxing. And if we are feeling stressed or anxious, that when we fill our mind with images that crowd out all of room for God, prayer involves a renewing of the mind and a two-stage process of purging out what displeases God and damages me, and allowing God to fill my mind with what matters far more. So again, it's that clearing our mind and being mindful of how we can connect with God, but also perhaps what displeases God and almost displeases us in a way, that we're given that space and that opportunity for God to almost like cleanse us and to cleanse our minds with images of prayer and beauty and just whatever is on our hearts, what we want to be thankful or even pray for. We're given that room within our space of mind for God to fill it up with beauty and, I guess, again, a peace of mind, and also like sanctuary, and almost God giving us righteousness, for us to be able to pray and just kind of reflect on if something we've done wrong or if we have been guilty of not praying, that God gives us that peace of mind and time for reflection.